In the last video lesson, I taught you how to add integers. Now, how do you subtract integers? That's what we're going to talk about today. Thank you for checking out my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. If this is the first video that you're watching from my channel, I make educational and motivational content. So if you don't want to miss any of the upcoming video lessons, don't forget to hit subscribe and hit that bell icon. Now, itong video na ito ay part ng ating series revamp for our integers series. Kasi yung aking original na integers videos are quite old, and I guess I could explain those things in a better way, hopefully, and give you options on how to solve it. So yun yung gagawin natin dito sa video na ito. Now, if you haven't seen my last video, yung adding integers, you can click right here to watch that and catch up. Ngayon, subtracting ang pag-uusapan natin. Now, before we switch over to my PC so I can explain it better to you, this hoodie that I'm wearing is yung Trying Hard hoodie natin. This is exclusive sa Team Laika shop. The link will be below, shop.teamlaika.com. You can go there to order your own. This comes in gray and black. You can pick out which one you want. Pwede rin yung ating cap that you see right here. And just represent yung team natin wherever you go. So now that it's time to explain yung ating lesson, I'm going to switch over to my PC. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, so this is part 2 of our lesson on integers. We're going to talk about subtracting integers here. Okay, if you haven't seen the first part yet, I couldn't stress this enough. Go ahead and watch that first para makuha niyo yung concept muna, okay? Now, there are just certain terms that we need to brush up on here. So, mayroong parts yung pinaka-equation na subtraction. Yung first number is what we call the minuend. And yung second number is what we call the subtrahend. So, kung 10 minus 1, 10 yung ating minuend, 1 naman yung ating subtrahend. Why does it matter? Kasi mamaya, papangalanan ko sila dun sa ginagawa. So basically, kung ano yung binabawas mo is the subtrahend, kung saan mo siya binabawas, yun yung minuend. Now, paano mo mas madaling matatandaan ito? Okay, ito yung technique ko, especially if you have younger kids na ganito yung mga exams nila. What you could say would be this, subtrahend kasi siya yung second. Okay? Siya yung second or pangalawa doon sa equation. So, ang minuend, siya yung nauuna. Tapos, yung second, yung subtrahend kasi it starts with the letter S. Okay? Just to help you better remember things. Now, when it comes to subtracting integers, ano yung gagawin natin? The first thing is, okay, kaya ni meron tayong equation na ganito. Step 1, you have to change the operation into addition. So, yung 4 minus 6 magiging 4 plus 6. Okay, na-change natin yung operation into addition. Step number 2, you're going to have to change the sign of the subtrahend. So again, subtrahend S, papalitan mo yung sign ng second number. So yung 6 used to be, ano to, positive. Ngayon, gagawin natin siyang negative. So magiging 4 plus negative 6. And then, all we have to do now is to complete the operation. So 4 plus negative 6, okay, ang gagawin natin dyan, again, subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. 6 minus 4 is 2. At ikokopya lang natin yung sign ng mas malaking number, which is negative. So, negative 2. Now, paano kung ganito? Okay? So, kanina, 4 minus 6 or 4 minus positive 6. Ngayon, 4 minus negative 6. Again, step 1, change the operation into addition. So, magiging 4 plus siya. Tapos, next, we're going step 2, we're going to change the sign of the subtrahend. So, negative 6 magiging positive 6 siya. And now that we have that, all we have to do is to complete the operation. So, 4 plus positive 4 plus positive 6, same na sila ng sign, so that is 10. And then, what we're going to do is just copy the sign. So, positive 10 or 10. Okay? So, again, first, change the operation, change the sign of the second number, and then you just complete the operation. Now, paano kung ganito? So, we're just playing around with multiple na mga combinations nitong same numbers. Pero this time, nauuna yung negative. So, again, first thing, change the operation into addition. So, magiging addition siya, plus 6. And then, change the sign of the subtrahend, magiging negative 6. And then, complete the operation. So, you have negative 4 plus negative 6. Pareho sila ng sign, pareho na silang negative. So, i-add mo lang sila, 4 plus 6 is 10. And then, copy the sign, which is negative. The answer is negative 10. Okay? Now, another combination, no? Pareho na ngayon silang negative. So, negative 4 minus negative 6.
Step 1, change the operation into addition. So, magiging plus siya. And then, change natin yung sign ng subtrahend. Yung negative 6 magiging positive 6. And then, follow through with the operation. So, negative 4 plus 6. Ang gagawin natin again, isusubtract natin dahil magkaiba sila ng sign. 6 minus 4 na lang. So, you have 2. And then, copy the sign of the bigger number, which is 6. So, the answer is positive 2 or 2. So, if you see there, dun sa apat na examples natin, pinapalit-palitan lang natin yung sign, nagpapalit-palit siya ng sagot. This is why it's very important for you to take note of the integers pagdating sa exams. Kasi usually, kung nakakalimutan yung isang rule, lalo na kung mahaba yung operation, nagkakamali tayo hanggang dulong sagot. So, there's no better way for me to check kung nakuha ninyo yung technique or nakuha ninyo yung process, kundi sa isang quiz. You have a few minutes to answer these 5 questions and I hope you get them right. Alright? Your timer starts now. Alright, let's see how you did. So let's start with the first one. This is negative 16 minus negative 34. So again, ang gagawin natin would be change natin muna yung operation to addition. So addition na siya. And then change yung sign ng pangalawang number. So positive na siya. Now you have negative 16 plus positive 34. Tapos dahil magkaiba sila ng sign, ibabawas natin yung 16 dito. So 34 minus 16. So you have 18 here. Tapos, kukopyahin natin yung sign ng mas malaking number, which is 34. So, the answer is positive 18. Okay? Number 2, we have negative 29 minus 74. Again, change the operation to addition. And then, change natin yung sign ng 74. Dati siyang positive, ngayon negative na siya. At dahil pareho na sila ngayon ng sign, negative at negative, i-add lang natin talaga sila. So, 74 plus 29. Or again, chunking, babawas na lang natin yung isa dito, magiging 73 siya para magiging 30 ito. 30 plus 70 is now 100 plus 3, that is 103. At dahil pareho silang negative, ang sign niya ay negative. So, negative 103. Alright? Number 3, negative 7 minus 99. So, again, change natin yung operation into addition. At dahil ito ay positive dati, gagawin na natin siyang negative ngayon. Pareho na sila ng sign, pareho na silang negative. So, all we have to do now is to add them together. So, 99 plus 7 is 106. At kopya lang ng sign, negative 106 ang sagot. Okay? Number 4, negative 76 minus 98. So, again, change the operation to addition. And then, ibabawas natin ngayon ito. Magiging negative siya kasi dati siyang positive, change mo rin yung sign ng subtrahend. So, now you have negative 76 plus negative 98. Again, i-add mo na lang sila dahil pareho sila ng sign. So, gagawin mo na lang. Pwede mo i-complete ito na gawin na lang 100 ito. Bawasan na lang natin siya ng dalawa. This is 74. The answer is 174. Tapos negative dahil pareho silang negative. Okay? So, again, ang ginagamit ko dito, kaya ganyan ako mag-add, is chunking. So, malaking help yan sa exam kasi sa akin lang, mas mabilis siya mag-mental math if you do that kesa yung mag-carry-carry ka pa. Pero actually, pareho rin yung sagot kung gagawin nyo yun kasi 98 plus 76, mangyayari dyan, 8 plus 6 is 14, carry on, 10, 7. So, again, whatever way you choose, kung saan kayo mas mabilis, stick with that. Okay? Basta ang final answer, negative 174. Next, we have this. Okay? So, again, nagma-minus tayo. Palit-palit ng sign. Ang gagawin lang natin, you can go from left to right. Okay? So, dito muna tayo. 93 minus negative 3. So, plus, plus. Okay? Papalitan natin yung operation and then yung sign. So, now you have 93 plus 3 or 96. And then, minus negative 75. Again, change this operation, change this sign. So, now you have 96 plus 75. Again, para makompleto ito maging 100, babawas ko na lang dito yung 4. So, this will be 71 instead. And then, now you have 171. At dahil pareho na silang positive, kukopihin mo lang yung sign that is positive 171 or 171 na lang. Okay? So, I hope you got that right. I hope you got all 5 questions right. Pero if you didn't, that's okay. Ang importante, practice lang para matuto kayo ng gusto. And again, I'll be posting more questions on this sa aking Instagram account. So, if you don't follow me yet on Instagram, follow me at Laika Maravilla for more quick questions. That's a story yan. Merong feature sila na quick quiz. So you can find out kung tama o mali kayo right away. I hope pag sumagot kayo doon, tama na kayo. Okay?
Alright, I hope you learned something today. If you did, click thumbs up. Make sure that you share this video with your friends, lalo na kung mag-exam sila. That way, mas marami tayong matutulungan. And as always, if you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. And if you have any questions, requests, comments, or kung meron kayong gusto malaman tungkol sa mga reviewers that I make, online or live review events, you can go to www.facebook.com/teamlaika for more information. Thanks guys for watching. As we always say, dito sa team, never stop learning. Keep trying hard. Aja, aja. Kaya niyan. I'll see you in my next video and bye for now.